I am Roe D. Roe.
This is brand new to me.
I was a local radio icon.
I didn't abide by the rules.
Thanks to haters, it came to an end.
I had to figure out my voice and my brand.
What's changed in 2 decades? I've grown up, married my college love, and interviewed real bosses from all over.
I eliminate the cell phone employee.
Grind for the net. Put in the work. Become a master. This is Network Master. Network Master, brought to you by Direct Sales 101. Calculate the GDP of your current network. You'd be amazed at how much wealth visits your family barbecue. Download the book as well. Visit www.directsales101.us to download free. Network Master in our second full month right here on WOKV. Want to say thanks for helping us make it through the first month. Coming up in today's show, Emma Collins, owner from Amelia Island, Florida, talks about going mobile in her business. Plus, Stephen Kelly, doing good for his community, his family, and those in need. We'll talk to him just a bit later. Right now, we've got local, I don't know what you call it, nonprofit founder, organizer, CEO, right here on Network Master, Brian Baker of Grace Life Ministries of Jacksonville. Welcome.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
So tell us a little bit about your background and what you do.
Well, right now here in Jacksonville, we started up our home ministry of Grace Life Ministries in Jacksonville, where we wanted to help the local community with different things that is going on out there. I really appreciate just being able to be a part of the plan for helping the community.
So have you guys been around for a while, or are you just starting up?
No, actually, it's only been since the start of the year, officially, with the IRS.
Okay. He said officially with the IRS.
Yes.
There's official and then there's unofficial, right?
Yes, yes. Officially, that way we're able to work with people and be an actual 501c3 nonprofit organization.
Now, what's that mean to a giver, persons that are giving to the ministry?
Well, you're talking about someone giving and being able to use that when they do their tax return and things like that. So we have to have a tax ID number to be recognized by the federal government so that we're not just taking money and then people can't get anything done with their taxes at the end of the year.
Gotcha. Because there is a tax benefit right now for giving to local charities and ministries. What types of things are you guys using your donations for right now?
Right now, we've done things like backpack outreaches. We've helped feed the homeless throughout the year. There have been different times where people have had to pay some bills and were short at times. So it's just a different variety of things that we've been trying to do with different people in the community.
Paying some bills, backpacks and stuff like that. You guys are getting on the ground level and doing a lot of great stuff, sounds like.
Actually, because you want to think about practical needs when you're looking out there in the community. Sometimes we look at the spiritual aspect of things, but we don't talk about just practical things like tires, batteries, you know, things that you have to use throughout the week.
That father that needs to get to work, if that tire is flat or punctured or can't make it to work, I mean, that's a day's wages lost. What are the people saying to you when you're able to help them out?
The people in the community, they're really, really appreciative of it, because I understand when you're trying to take care of business and you're looking at something like getting a battery. Batteries are expensive. If you ever had to get one.
Oh, yeah.
You're talking about $130 on a good day.
What?
And most people don't put that in their regular budget for the week or for the month. So those things are necessary for people to continue to do what they need to do.
We're talking to Brian Baker. He's founder of Grace Life Ministries of Jacksonville. Brand new ministry. Why is he on Network Master? Because you know what? There are some elements of starting a ministry that have to deal with business. What are some things you guys have learned so far?
One of the biggest things is understanding that you have to have a budget. It's just like any other business. You have to have a budget. You just can't do anything. You have to look at your revenue, and you have to look at the expenses, and you don't want to be in the red just like any other business. You know, you have to do that in order to be able to function and help people throughout the year. So you have to look at budgeting and aspects of making sure that you're being a good steward with the money that you do have.
So you said budget, you said steward. There are some people who believe that a ministry should just go by the seat of their pants, sing kumbaya on Wednesday and Sunday, and hopefully things work out. Does that rub some people the wrong way?
Well, for me, I could never see just doing anything. I mean, that's just not my nature. I have a business degree from my own background, so I could never see just, well, let's just buy whatever, because eventually you're going to be broke, okay? And then you can't do anything, and you can't help people if you're broke.
Hmm. Wow, amazing stuff right now on Network Master. Visit the website, networkmaster.live. Download the audio and share it with your friends, family, friends, and network. Right now, let's get to the Network Master phone lines. Give us a call, 904-770-5925. Who's on the line?
Anna.
Thanks, Anna, for calling. What area are you from?
The West Side.
West Side. Okay, you have a question for Brian Baker of Grace Life Ministries of Jacksonville?
My question is, if God is able to create the heaven and earth, why is it that he needs my money for me to donate to the church every week?
Ooh. Oh, okay. She went hardcore off the bat, right?
Yeah.
Go ahead. I'm going to leave it to you.
Well, you know, there are some practical things that we have to deal with in the world, and money is a tool that allows us to do things. If I go to the grocery store and I want to get some groceries, I can't go to the cashier and say, well, I'm just going to pay for this with prayer sandwich money, right? That's not going to work. I'm just going to give you some blessings and I'm going to walk out the store.
Hmm.
We can't do that. There are practical aspects of things where we have to make sure that we're paying the businesses for the services and the products that they provide
to us. Right.
I mean, it's just like any other business out there. So if we need to get some clothes or some backpacks, or we need to be able to provide some type of materials, school supplies, we can't go up to a place and say, well, thank you for all of the supplies, and we have like $2,000 worth of equipment, and we're going to give you a blessing. Well, that's just not going to work.
That doesn't fly, does it?
No, it's not going to work, because that's called theft, all right? So we have to have practical aspects of our faith where we're actually paying for the things that we're using.
Are you from the Jacksonville, Florida originally?
Yes, I am. Born and raised right here in Jacksonville.
Born and raised. One of the last of the Mohicans here. So what high school did you come out of?
Graduated from Stanton.
Stanton Prep.
Oh, yes.
Hey, okay. So are you a nerd?
Yes.
But the good nerd, right? Tell us a little bit more about your education and your background.
Well, it's helped me out a lot. From the time that I graduated from high school and I went on to college for a couple of years before joining the Army.
Hmm.
And then after I got out of the Army after 8 years of service, continued my education, got a Bachelor of Science in Business, Master of Arts in Management.
Wow.
And now I've moved on into the healthcare field.
Thank you for your service. Real quick, what did you do while you were in the Army?
I was actually a corrections officer in the Army.
Corrections officer?
Yes, worked in a prison.
Okay, I'm going to just leave it at that. So then you came back home, and what do you do now?
Like I said, I've been working in the healthcare industry for the last 10 years.
Okay. And so now you've got the Grace Life Ministries of Jacksonville started up. You're learning a lot in your first year. Give us a couple quick tips that could be good for anybody starting a business or a nonprofit here.
Yes. One of the biggest things you need to do is research.
Hmm.
Research, research, research. You can never know too much.
Hmm.
You have to be able to understand what the industry is about. You have to understand what you're trying to accomplish and what's been going on before you got into the industry itself.
Okay, when people think ministry, they don't think you have to do any research. And when you say industry, they may even say, wait a minute, is church really an industry? So how do you research for starting a nonprofit like that?
Well, it's just like any other business. You have to be able to understand the demographics of people in that particular area, what
okay.
their needs are. You also have to realize what the laws are in regards to the financial aspects of things. There's a lot of things that you have to do in terms of taxes and revenues and all of those things. There, it's just like any other business in that regard.
Wait a minute. So even though the church itself may be a not-for-profit 501c3 organization, there are still tax issues to deal with?
Oh, yes. Yes, you got to deal with the taxes. I mean, you're bringing in all of this revenue from different locations. You have to be able to explain where it all went.
Hmm.
Okay,
hmm.
So that doesn't change.
Hmm. So as we go further into that rabbit hole of starting a business and being able to manage it properly, I'm guessing when people give you donations, you have to be able to help them be able to account at tax time too, right?
Absolutely. Yeah,